subscriber. And yeah, definitely a very tough, frustrating game. I didn't realize, let me not say that. It didn't take me long to realize that this young gentleman had a custom playbook filled with like every amazing run in the game. So he starts off with a buck sweep, and I'm the Cowboys, he's the Lions, and then he goes on ahead and hits me with the buck sweep read option, hits the outside, nice little slow spin move by Matthew Stafford for a gain of 8, and he runs the ball very heavily, and very, very effective at it. As we all know, I struggle against the run very, very much. You know, I always prepare for the pass. And when somebody continuously runs the ball with some of the runs being the better runs of the game, it's not good luck for me, right? So our first play, we give it to DeMarco Murray. We hit the outside and he can go. Oh, the way as DeMarco Murray hits the outside. And we end up scoring a touchdown, tying up the game 7-7. Then we go back again on defense trying to stop the multiple amazing runs that he has in store for us. So right here, man, he goes to a strong close, nice little toss play. We had the angle, but unfortunately we kept going down instead of cutting him off, which is always frustrating. So right here again got us with another two pulling guard run. And again, he's chuck full of them. So first and 10 right here again. He goes back to the buck sweep. And I can't stop. I just need to know, I need to prepare for it. Like, if I don't, then that run is it can cause a lot of problems. It definitely can. Right here, he rolls out with Stafford, goes over the middle, and we bet that down. 3rd and 12 right here. Let's see if we can make a hole into a field goal. Then he goes to his wing formation and he goes over the middle. We drop an interception, which is definitely always frustrating, especially on a 3rd and long. We could have prevented that field goal, but at least we held them to not scoring a touchdown. So 10-7 right here. We go back again, and let's see if we can go on ahead and continue to put, pressure on his offense. I want to get him passing the ball, So I got to get him out of his runs, and in order to do that, a nice heavy dosage of being able to score quickly and often, he should then feel like, okay, he needs to do the same to keep up. And, I just got to get him into passing, because he's running the ball down my throat, and I'm not doing a good job of stopping it whatsoever. So 1st and 10, we run to the outside again, but that time we get shut down. 2nd level, we go back to the run. 3rd and 4, this is a very big play. We decide to go to our pistol formation. I am running Kansas City playbook, and we go to the strong power, get ourselves a 1st down. Right, we try to go to Desitron, but unfortunately he drops the ball due to contact, and that right there sucked. I would have loved to have had that. Right, just a quick little out route gives us the touchdown, and now we go up 14-10. And we do receive ball at halftime. So that right there is always a big factor to keep in mind. If we can get a stop here, get ball at halftime, score, game could possibly be over. We'll be up, multiple possessions. And, he should definitely be out of his run by then. So let's see if we can go on ahead and force that. So he rolls outside the pocket, passing the ball a little bit more on 3rd and 11. Nice in route right there. He just was able to grab onto that. Right there, like I said, if I'm predicting buck sweep, I will stop it. It just sucks when I'm predicting it and it's a pass, or if I'm predicting a pass and then it's buck sweep. So that time I was right, prepared for it, and he ran it. So 22 seconds remaining, dropped what out, man, just good play. At least we stopped it, right? So it goes back up the middle with Reginald Bush, and Reggie is just tearing us apart. He's got like 200 yards rushing at this point, and he is just destroying us. When you go up against the Lions, you definitely feel like you need to pay a lot of attention to Calvin Johnson. I mean, why wouldn't you? He's the best receiver in the game. He's a huge threat. Anytime the ball is in his hands, he can make a lot of plays happen, especially after the catch. So he's a very dominant receiver that I'm trying my best to, keep tabs on. And for me, I don't even know why, because he's dominating me with the run, not even looking to pass. So we go into halftime down 3, but we have the opportunity to go on ahead and score again and, reclaim the lead. First play, we go to a quick little play to whoop, double juke, no! And DeMarco Murray again takes another big play to the crib. That right there rekindles our, I don't know what I was going to say. I meant to say, reclaim our lead, but I said rekindle. So did we rekindled our confidence. There we go. So 21-17 at this point. Again, he's running the ball down our throat. We gotta stop him. Trying my best to clog up the outside because most of his runs are designed to hit the outside. So like I said, I'm trying my best to clog that up. You know, when you go up against somebody who habitually runs two pulling guards or anything where their runs are based towards the outside, you want to clog up, you know, the outside. You want to be able to have those guards commit to somebody early, because if those guards can actually reach the outside, it's pancake haven out there, and you don't want that. So 3rd and 2 right here, this right here will be a big stop, and that's exactly what we get. 4th and 4, can we finally manage to stop? And he calls a run play. I mean, I'm definitely not expecting that on a 4th and 4. So good play. I'm definitely prepared for the pass, and he sneaks a run on me. 10 rushes for 100 some odd yards, almost 200, absolutely just slicing and dicing us. We stopped a run right there. 4th and 14, I had him shaded to the outside. Look, notice he was playing the outside because I knew that was coming. You know, he caught me in a man-to-man. I had edge thing, and he no-huddled after that 3rd down run fail. And then I seen Calvin Johnson, man, I'm not going to press because he's going to destroy any press. So I got him 15 yards off of the ball, and I know he's going to go to an out route. I shade him to the outside, and it just didn't work. Right here, we finally get ourselves a stop. Sean Lee's like, no, some of you, give it to me, baby. Oh, and he takes it all the way for a pick six. Pick six. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That right there was definitely a huge shift of momentum, because at that point, we really did not stop each other at all. He was scoring, I was scoring, he was scoring, I was scoring. Just going back and forth, and we finally catch a break. He did go to an out route, but we had a purple route sitting pretty waiting for that, and he throws right into coverage, and thankfully, well, it wouldn't have mattered even if he picked it out. It was 4th down. It still would have been our ball, but he did catch the interception, and he actually held on to it and took it all the way for 6. So that right there was big, keeping my offense off the field. You know, so again, putting the pressure on him, but he's still not giving up the run. You know, as much success as he's having with the run, I mean, can't blame him. Again, continuously running. You know, at this point, I'm starting to key in on the run a little bit. I know you're like, GS, you're 200 yards too late to key in on the run in the 4th quarter. I know. Dropped interception right there, but that doesn't matter because the very next play, he drops back and he throws a pick. And again, Sean Lee comes up with it. If you look back at the play, he had a wheel route to the right side that was butt naked. Like possibly a touchdown, easily a 1st down, possibly even a touchdown. But he decided to throw over the middle, and we had Sean Lee right there hawking with the yellow route, and he comes down with it. So what was once a close game at 17-14, me being down, just absolutely turned into a blowout. I wouldn't call it a blow, but we end up just making ourselves a very comfortable victory. Him throwing back-to-back interceptions, which was huge. And that's what we needed to do against somebody with, you know, so many dynamic runs that he has. You know, take him away from the run, and we did not do that whatsoever. You know what I mean? But the few times that we did, we were able to cause some interceptions, which was big. And that was the difference in the game. So that's the end of the game, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed. As always, your boy GS. I'm out. Peace. Give it to me, baby. I've been thinking about you. You know, no, no. I've been thinking about you. Oh, no, no, no. I've been thinking about you. Do you think about me still? Do ya? Do ya?